Hello and welcome to my channel. I'd like to share with you today how I work on one of my pages in my handmade traveller's journal. I don't necessarily work from the beginning of the book, I just pick a page that I want to work on. Place my greaseproof paper or tracing paper behind each page. I actually like using this blue glue, which shows up blue, which is quite handy, especially when you're gluing your collage pieces, so you can see the coverage you have. To start with, I glue the whole of the page. And then I fold the page in, and then I burnish from outside in. The burnishing tool I'm using is actually an old sock. And I do the same with the other side of the page. I put quite a lot of glue on the page. And once again, fold the page over. And I simply let it fall and then burnish from the outside in. That helps to get air bubbles out of the page. To give a smooth centre, I'm using here masking tape. I place the masking tape down the centre of the page. Once again, I use my burnishing tool. And then I cut off the edges. Then your page is ready to work on. You take your collage pieces. Now you glue them piece by piece. I tend to glue mine on a sheet of greaseproof paper, and then that helps for them not to stick to the table or anything else. Once again, you use your burnishing tool to get all the air bubbles out. You can actually move the piece if you do it quickly before it actually glues fully. If you've placed it a little off the edge or a little over the edge. This is quite a large piece of collage I'm using. I'm cutting it down to size now to hopefully fit the area. Sometimes it's better to cut a little larger than need be, because you can always cut with scissors when you've finished your piece of work. As you can see here, I'm playing around with the placing of the collage pieces. Thank you. I always like to burnish in the crease of the page. Be very careful when you're gluing small pieces. As you can see here, my piece split. But that's the thing with collage, it doesn't matter. You can always place it close to or use it separately on a different page. Neaten up the edges and cut quite close to the original page as you can. Thank you. When I got to this stage, I thought I was finished, but I thought, no, there's something missing. So as you can see here, I've added some few extra bits. Always place your pieces down to see what they look like before you actually glue them. The first stage of this page is complete. The next stage will be the mark making and the journaling, and then I'll have to find a nice quote. I hope you've enjoyed my tutorial, and thank you for watching.